in the face of COVID, of the COVID-19 pandemic and the restrictions associated and disruptions associated with COVID-19 pandemic, the countries, the malaria endemic countries, have managed to avert the worst case scenarios that many, including WHO, predicted could happen. So that's a first and very important positive message. Nonetheless, there has been an extra 47,000 extra deaths due to those associated disruptions. We are globally off track in terms of reaching our 2030 targets, and that divergence from the trajectory we should be following from the one we're actually following continues to increase. So this is a big wake-up call that unless we do something decisive and urgently, key targets will not be achieved. On the one hand, more countries than ever, more than half of all malaria endemic countries, are actually close to eliminating completely the disease within their national boundaries. And indeed, this year we've witnessed the success of having the largest malaria endemic country in the world, China, being certified malaria-free, and also one of the smallest countries in the world, El Salvador, being certified malaria-free, and a whole set of other countries are lined up to be certified malaria-free. On the other side of the equation, some of the high-burden countries, mostly in sub-Saharan Africa, continue to bear a disproportionate brunt of the disease, and a substantial number of them are actually worsening their malaria situation with respect to what they had in 2015. So a mixed picture, but globally we are off track. This year has been an extraordinary year. On October the 6th, the Director General of WHO, following the advice of external advisory bodies and the results of the malaria vaccine implementation program, announced for the first time in history that WHO recommended a malaria vaccine, a first generation malaria vaccine, to be deployed broadly to children living in areas of moderate to high transmission. This announcement is now being followed by the decision by the Gavi board to open up a window of funding for a malaria vaccine to reach those that need it. The significance of these two announcements, first the WHO recommendation, secondly the Gavi endorsement, is, I believe, truly historical. We need new tools. With the tools we have right now, we can save lives, and we have saved lives, but we cannot imagine that we will go on making the type of progress that is needed. We need also technological tools, we need new vaccines, we need new medicines, and the fact that for the first time a malaria vaccine can join the other tools that we have to more effectively fight malaria, to reduce what we estimate an extra 40 to 80,000 deaths of African children every year, is a scientific and public health breakthrough.